Waves are a defining characteristic of the seashore and a source of recreation to beachgoers, but they can also cause significant damage during extreme storms, drastically eroding sediment while pounding the shore relentlessly. Such storms can also carry waves much farther inland, bringing severe flooding and destroying near-coast houses and infrastructure. One possible nature-based solution being examined to mitigate the effects of severe coastal events is mangroves.
The benefits of coastal mangroves are that they reduce wave energy and trap sediment, which helps to reduce storm impacts inland and prevent erosion of the shoreline. They also serve as a valuable habitat for coastal life.
Furthermore, these trees block wind across the water's surface, preventing waves from reforming. Studies have shown that mangroves can reduce the height of waves by as much as 66%. Hoping to maximize this natural fortification, researchers from the U.S. Army Engineer Research and Development Center and the U.S. Naval Academy are collaborating to learn more about how to most effectively use mangroves to reduce coastal damage caused by waves. This innovative project is part of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers' Engineering with Nature initiative, which supports more sustainable water resources outcomes by intentionally aligning natural and engineering processes.
So mangroves provide a critical ecological and engineering service that needs to be quantified so that districts and the nation can make educated decisions and optimized designs. Both the ecological and engineering benefits provided by mangroves is dependent on the hydrodynamic processes that occur within a mangrove forest. Past research conducted on mangroves were done at smaller scales, which limits the interpretation of results for coastal storms.
Oftentimes, the greatest challenge in collecting mangrove field data has been their environment.
Mangroves typically live along the boundary between land and sea in low-energy, salty environments that can be difficult to access, instrument, and monitor. This, coupled with the intermittency of high-energy events like tropical storms, reduces the likelihood of capturing hydrodynamics during critical events. This lends itself to using a physical model. Another case for using a physical model is in the laboratory, we can create a very controlled system to investigate the effects of specific parameters like stem density. This allows us to eliminate some of the inherent uncertainty and variability associated with field studies.
The research team employed a multidisciplinary approach in order to replicate those field-like conditions.
We wanted to build a diverse group of researchers with backgrounds in coastal waves, physical modeling, and coastal ecology to help plan and build a physical model that would capture critical hydrodynamics. So this model spans the water levels and waves typical of the day-to-day environment and higher energies associated with storms. Smaller scale studies struggle to capture both effectively and have issues when scaling up to a real-world system. The data collected in this model will be used to fill our knowledge gaps and provide engineering guidance for the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers.
The research team had to consider many variables in the creation of its near-scale model.
Anytime you build a mimic of a natural system, you want to make sure that that you're going to capture meaningful data. So you have to get the geometry correct and the physics correct, but you have to do so at affordable cost, right? So ultimately, we have to balance the cost and the scale with the getting data that can drive decisions. First thing we did was we went out and we reviewed the documentation on mangroves in the United States. We looked at stem diameter, prop roots, the number of stems in a given area, and ultimately that helped us assess, okay, how do mangroves grow in the United States? And we also used data from the U.S. Naval Academy to assess the structural properties of mangroves. And using this data, we were able to go through and look at the common building materials that would give us similar properties. And ultimately, that makes it affordable.
This research can benefit society because if we understand the performance of these natural systems, then we can effectively leverage this infrastructure to protect our coastal communities and also find a cost-effective way to mitigate flood damage.